In this video, I will discuss about helper functions in Coordinator 4. The helper functions are just a global functions which are used to simplify our work. They are not based on object-oriented approach, which means there is no extend keyword or we don't have to create an object for these classes. So these are simple PHP files which have global functions. So let's work on it. So open your code editor. I'm using my previous project. So here I have created a new controller which is named as helper test controller. Here I'll use helper functions. To use helper functions, first we have to include inside our project. To do this, we can simply use helper function inside our constructor. So just write helper. This function accept helper name. There are some predefined functions which are created by Coordinator 4 team. We will use one of them, or we can create our own helper function as well. So first, work on predefined helpers. First of all, I'll use date helper function. So just write date. By using this, now date helper is included in our controller. Let's create a function. I'll name it as show without any parameter. And here I'll simply print today's time. So there is a function named as now inside this helper class. So let's save this file and run our server and go to the web browser. So here is the current milliseconds. So if we comment this helper function and try to reload our page, then we'll get an error that this now function is not defined, which means this function is defined inside this the helper file. So there are few ways to load the helper. The first method is inside the constructor. By using helper function in constructor of controller, this means this function is available inside our whole class. But if we want to use these functions inside a single function, then we will simply move this helper inside our show function. Now this helper helper functions are only available inside this show function. So now save this file and reload the web page. Now we have the output. The another method is, if you have created a fresh Coordinator 4 project, then you will see that your controller is extended from the base controller, and the base controller is inside the controller directory. If you open this file, here is a variable named as helpers. So this is the same variable which is worked as helper function. So if we comment this helper function and if we load this date helper inside this variable and try to reload our web page, then we will get our output again. And now this time this date helper function is available in all controllers which are extended from this base controller. So I'm simply using this helper function inside our controller. So let's talk about other helper functions as well. So now I'll use file system helper. So just include it, file system. If you want to check all files inside current directory, then we can use directory map. So just use directory underscore map and here pass directory initial directory. So I'm passing dot as current directory as initial directory, and our current directory is the public directory because our PHP code run from this public directory. So if we save this file and reload our web page, then we'll get an array and we have a CSS, which is also an array, which means this CSS is a directory. And there is a file style.css, and there is another file favicon.ico. If we go inside our public directory, then you can see we have that CSS folder, and there is a style.css file, and all these files are listed here. So this is the use of helper functions. So there is one more interesting function inside this file system helper, which is for creating or appending a file. So let's do this. The name of that function is write_file. So path will be the root directory, which is public, and I'm going to create a new file which is named as a long.txt file, and I'll write the content as created using file system helper function. So let's print its output. Okay, now reload the web page. I have to write this file with the directory name. Now save this and reload our web page. Now the output is 1, which means it's success. Let's see. Okay, so here is a new file which is named as prolong.txt. So if I open that file, there is a content which is created using file system helper function. So this is how we use helper functions in our Coordinator 4 project. We can also load that helper using the autoloader inside the config directory, which is named as autoload. We will discuss about this in next videos. So just stick with the local initialization of the helper function. Thank you for watching this video. Please subscribe to my channel and share with your friends as well, so I can create more valuable content for you. Follow us on other social media accounts as well. Links are in description of this video.